Hey, fourth graders, welcome to page 126, the second half of your review, procesando all the important information about fractions, right? Okay, so yesterday I introduced to you that one way we can reduce fractions, because look at page 126, number 5 says that we're gonna reduce fractions, that one way we could do it is start with 2, okay? Now that manera, you guys, that manera of dividiendo por dos, we only want to use that if we can't find the other number. But let's repasar, how do we find the real number that we're gonna divide by, okay? Remember what we do our factores. What are my factores of 3, Sama? 1 and 3, right? 1 times 3. What are my factores of 9, Keanu? 1 and 9, 1 times 9, then 3 times 3. So what number can I divide by, Kiara? What's my greatest common factor entre los dos? 3, okay, so we're gonna divide by the 3. So go ahead, Fernanda, what's my new fraction? 3 divided by 3 is 1, 9 divided by 3 is 3. There you go, 1 and 3. Can we divide any more? Can we take divide something by 1 and divide something by 3? No. So 1 divided by 3 is your answer. 1 over 3, pardon. Look at this one. Let's do our factores. Ready? 4. What are my factors of 4, Scarlett? 1 and 4. 2 times 2. Good. What are my factors of 12, Fernanda? 1 times 12. 2 times 6. 3 times 4, right? So what is my greatest common factor, Keanu, between these two numbers? 4, right? You have 1, 2, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. So 4 is the biggest one. So we're going to divide by 4. So what's my new fraction, Holly? 4 divided by 4 is 1. 12 divided by 4 is 3. And there's my answer. Now I'm gonna go to letter D, because letter D is a little hard, but not really. Actually, it might be the easiest one. I don't know, it depends on if you're following my process. Okay, what are my factors of 11, Jayla? 1 and 11. What are my factors of 22, Sama? 1 times 22, 2 times 11. Okay, so what's my greatest common factor, Scarlett? 11. Good. What's 11 divided by 11? Sama? 1. 22 divided by 11, Kayla? 2. So my answer is 1/2. Bada bing, bada boom. Go ahead and try letter D. No, pardon, C. I just did letter D. Try letter C by yourself and let's make sure that you understand. Okay, what are my factors of 6, Tiano? 1, 6, 2, 3. What are my factors of 18, Fernanda? 1, 18, 2, 9, 3, 6. Good. What's my greatest common factor, Holly, Holly? 6. So what's my answer, Kiara? 1 over 3. Good. I hope you got that. Okay, let's do number 6, letter A. Try it by yourself first. It says reduce if necessary. Try it by yourself first. Okay, how many got that answer? Raise your hand if you got that answer. Okay, you're almost there, but we needed to reduce because we can divide something by both these numbers. What can we divide? Well, what are your factors of 3, Salma?
1 and 3.
What are my factors of 12, Keanu?
1, 12, 2, 6, 3, 4.
Okay, what's my greatest common factor, Jayla?
3.
So here we go, here's our answer. 6, don't forget your whole number, and 1 over 4. Okay, but do letter B by yourself and decide, can you reduce that? Do letter B by yourself. Is this the answer you got? I hope so, because you can't reduce anything by 5 and 17. Your factors of 5 are 1 and 5. Your factors of 17 are 1 and 17. There's no greatest common factor there because 1 doesn't count. If you divide by 1 here, the fraction is going to be the same. Okay? So there you go. Now look at number 7. You guys know how to do this, but it looks a little funny, right? A little weird. So I just want to make sure that you understand what to do. It says 24 divided by 3 equals this. And this times 3 equals 24. All they're showing you here is that multiplication and division are just al revés, or just contrarios. What's 24 divided by 3, Fernanda?
8.
And what times 3 equals 24?
8.
Because if 24 divided by 3 equals 8, 8 times 3 equals 24. They're just al revés from each other. So every single answer here is going to be same over here if you're right. Okay? The rest of it I think you can do by yourself, and I want to see if you remember how to do that cuadro, the chart. Okay? So have fun. Bye. Have a great day. Thanks for working hard.